Welcome students, today we will discuss about the Boolean's law, which is very important to solve the Boolean expressions in the digital electronics. In the last class we have discussed about De Morgan's law, and we have two De Morgan's law. One is stated as the complement of the product is the sum of the complement, and in the Boolean expression we can write x dot y, the complement of x dot y is equal to x dash plus y dash, which is the sum of the complement. Now the second law states that complement of sum is the product of the complement. So if we have two elements which are in sum form and it is complemented, then it can be written in terms of the product of the complement. Here it is written x dash dot y dash. So these two theorems are basically De Morgan's law, and it can be generalized for n number of variables. Like if you have x, y, z, p, q, r, and so on. So if we have n number of variables, we can generalize these two theorems by using this formula. And this can be proved by using truth table as well. So now we will discuss other Boolean's law. De Morgan's law is also part of Boolean's law, but here we will discuss the Boolean's law in detail. So in this class you will be able to explain a different Boolean's law, and after knowing the Boolean's law you can solve or you can simplify the given Boolean expressions, or you can simplify the digital circuits. That is the application of the Boolean's law. So first we will discuss what is the Boolean expression. Boolean expressions are basically composed of two terms, which is called literals. These are variables, and we denote these variables by using some English alphabet, and literals may be also their complement. So either variables, that is uncomplemented symbols, or complemented symbols are the literals, which are also the variables. And the second one is the logical operations. Logical operations, basically we have already discussed about the AND operation, OR operation, and NOT operation. These operations are called logical operations. So we can say that in the Boolean expressions we will have literals and logical operations. Here you can see literals are A, B dash, C, or A dash, B, C dash. But the logical operations, which are here dot, which indicates the ending of the two variables, and plus, which is indicating the ORing of the two variables, and dash is indicating the NOT operation. So this is the example of a Boolean expression. And these Boolean expressions are realized using a network combination of logic gates. Here you can see that we have three AND gate, two NOT gate, and one OR gate, and by using these combination of logic gates we will get the Boolean expression of AB plus A dash B plus A dash B dash. So here literals are basically working as variables, or these are the inputs for the different logic gates, and these logic gates are basically the logic operations. So by using these two combinations we will get the Boolean expressions. This is the way we will get the expression, Boolean expressions. And we can evaluate Boolean expressions by substituting the value 0 or 1 for each bit row, because since it is a boolean and the state of the literals will be either 0 or 1, that is it will be either on or off, or you can say it will be either high or low. So we can substitute in terms of boolean expressions, like if you substitute 0 or 1, we can evaluate the expression. The truth table is also one of the way to express the boolean expression, and for n number of variables, the truth table has 2 power n rows. Why? Because each row has the combination of n variables. So this is the expression and the corresponding truth table, and how we can draw the truth table. We can use 2 power n rows for n number of variables. Now these are the basic laws and theorems in Boolean algebra. Here the first one is the commutative law. A plus B is equal to B plus A, and corresponding AND operation we can write A dot B is equal to B dot A. Similarly, we will have associative law, distributive law, null element, identity element, idempotence, complement, involution, absorption, simplification, De Morgan's rule, logical adjacency, and consensus. These are the basic Boolean's law. Few of these law we will discuss here. The proof here, idempotence, you can see A plus A is equal to A. And we can solve this Boolean expression by using this concept. The problem is given here. Similarly, A dot A is equal to A, and we can solve this given expression by using this formula, this law basically. Here we can also add additional terms by using this theorem. This is used when we solve, or when we will get the canonical form of min term, max term. This form will be used. The complement means the sum of the variable with its complement is equal to always 1, and this is generalized for a number of variables. Here if you see A, B, C dash, D plus A, B, C, D, that will be, if you take common, C dash plus C will be in the bracket, and that will be equal to 1. So we can write this F is equal to A, B, C. That is the final solution, or you can say simplification of the Boolean expression. Similarly, we can have A dot A dash is equal to 0, that can also be solved. Here is the distributive law, and in the distributive law says that A dot B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, but corresponding law, which is also the distributive law when we are using the AND operations. So here A plus B dot C is equal to A plus B dot A plus C, which is very important law, because this will be again used in getting the standard form of min term or max terms. So these are some Boolean expressions, and we can solve this by using the distributive law. So you can see here this problem wx plus y dot z. You can write wx plus y dot wx plus z, and it can be extended further or more than these variables. Here we have four variables w, x, y, z. Here are four variables. We can extend this for a number of variables. So this is the distributive law. Adoption is another very important law, in which if we have a plus ab, then we can write a, because if we take a common, that will be 1 plus b inside the bracket, and 1 plus b is always 1, so it will give you a. Similarly, here a dot a plus b is equal to a. So this is the absorption law, and these are some Boolean expressions, and by using the absorption law, we can solve the Boolean expression. So here, if you see this problem, d plus de plus def, here it is equal to d, because if we take common d from these two terms, we will get d into 1 plus f, which becomes 1. So we will get d, and now this d is again taken common, then we will get 1 plus e, and that will give you d. So similarly here, we can also use this absorption law to solve this expression. Simplification. This is the Boolean law. A plus A dash B is equal to A plus B. And this is called the simplification law, because we can write A plus A dash B as A plus A dash into A plus B. This is a distributive law for AND operation. So that will give you A plus A dash is always 1. Into a plus b, that is equal to a plus b. Again, we can see this is the given expression, and we can solve by using this simplification law. Logic adjacency means combining. This is the Boolean law, and if you take a outside, we'll get b plus b dash, which is equal to 0. So we'll again get A. This is the logic adjacency, and this law is used to solve various Boolean expressions. Here is the example, see, and that is solved by using this law. Similarly, here A plus B dot A plus B dash is equal to A. This can be also proved. Dual of a Boolean expression. Dual of a Boolean algebraic expression is obtained by interchanging and OR operations and replacing the corresponding 1Rs and 2Rs by zeros and 1Rs. So here you have given equation, two equations, and these two equations are valid. If we replace dot by plus and the plus by dot, this dot indicates and plus indicates or. So these two equations are, you can say, these two expressions are equivalent, and it is because of the dual of Boolean expression. So this is the duality, and we can see here in the theorem x dot x is equal to x in AND form, but here if we replace AND by OR, then again it will be true, x plus x is equal to x. If you take the values, that is, if we suppose x dot 0, then it will be 0, and if we change it by using duality principle, dual of Boolean expression, then dot is replaced by plus and 0 is replaced by 1, so that becomes x plus 1 is equal to 1. So this is a very important law. These two theorems are very important, and in most of the Boolean's law, these two theorems are used. These are some practice questions you will be able to solve by using different Boolean law. And the solutions are given. Similarly, you can solve other problems by using these books. The books, these problems are given, so you can get help from these books to further solve the problems. Thank you.